So in today's video, we're going to introduce the topic of something called a line integral. Now, a line integral is something of a cross between a single integral and a double integral. Because in our situation, the quote-unquote region of integration is going to be something like a curve or a thin wire or potentially a string. Now, because a string is essentially one-dimensional, it's something like a straight line that has just been a little bit bent out of shape. These line integrals have a one-dimensional nature to them. But because curves live in two-dimensional space, these line integrals also have a two-dimensional element, essentially 1D, but living in 2D space. So line integrals are partially double integrals and in part single integrals. And we'll talk more precisely about what that means in today's lecture. Today we're going to calculate the line integral of a multivariable function over a parameterized curve. And then we're going to use line integrals in certain applications. And we're going to start first with the mass and the center of mass of a curved wire. Okay, so let's informally define a line integral. To begin with, you have some function f of xy, a function of two variables, And then you have some smooth curve, let's call it C, which lives in two-dimensional space, as in the drawing that we gave on the previous page. The line integral is indicated by a single integral symbol, and a single closing ds on the right-hand side with a subscript corresponding to the curve C. And then we have our function f of xy as the integrand. This quantity represents a cumulative total of all the outputs of f of xy over the curve C. So as an example, if we have C representing an actual physical wire or an actual physical piece of string, and we have some function rho of xy, which measures the density of the wire at a certain point, then if you integrate the density function using this line integral, you'll get the overall total mass of this curved wire or piece of string. Now, to actually calculate line integrals, we use a special formula to transform them into single integrals as follows. The first thing that you need to do is you need to find a parameterization for that curve C that you're given. Let's call it R of T, and let's call its component functions X of T, Y of T, for A between T between A and B. Once you have found a parameterization of your curve C, integrate as t goes from a to b with respect to t the following integrand. You take your function f, but instead of just having the variable x there, you have the variable x of t from your parameterization. And replace the y in your function with the y of t from your parameterization. And finally, multiply that by an extra factor, just like we did in our triple and double integrals. Multiply that by essentially the length, the velocity, r of t, the speed, I should say, where we have dx dt, that derivative squared, and we have dy dt, that derivative squared. So, put another way, this red quantity is the speed, r prime of t. That is how we calculate line integrals. Integrate as t goes from a to b, the function where x has been replaced with the x of the parameterization, y has been replaced with the y of the parameterization, and then multiply by the speed of the parameterization the magnitude of r prime. All right, let's put that formula into practice in the following example. A wire has the shape of a semicircle. X squared plus y squared equals 4. Y greater than or equal to 0. Suppose that the density of the wire at the point xy is given by the function rho of xy equals 2x plus y plus 1. Find the total mass, and then let's find the center of mass. Alright, before we do anything, first we need to find a parameterization for the wire, just as we did back in calculus 3. So let's sketch the wire, which is consists of the circle of radius 2 drawn for y greater than or equal to 0. Now, from calculus 3, you might recall that circle shapes were generally parameterized in a pretty consistent way using the cosine and sine functions. We would let x of t, for example, be radius times cosine of t, and y of t be radius times sine of t. And this would be valid for t, the angle between 0, corresponding to the right half of this circle, and t equals pi, corresponding to the left half. All right, so we found a parameterization for the wire. So the next thing that we need to work on is trying to get an expression for this integrand that we had in our formula, f of x of t, y of t, times the speed of the parameterization. Okay, so let's calculate r prime of t. Component-wise, we have negative 2 sine t and 2 cosine t. And if we calculate the speed of that, we have the square root of the x component squared plus the square root plus the y component squared, quantity square root, which gives us, after a little simplification, 4 sine squared t plus 4 cosine squared t. Now, sine squared plus cosine squared always reduces to 1. So in total, this quantity reduces to 4, root 4 being 2. And so here is the speed that we're using as part of our integrand. Finally, with f of x, y, equal to the given function 2x plus y plus 1, let's find f of x of t, y of t. In other words, everywhere we see an x in the formula, let's replace it with the x of our parameterization. And every time we see a y in the formula, let's replace it with the y of our parameterization. So not 2x, but 2 times 2 cosine t. In x's place. Not plus y, but now plus 2 sine t, which simplifies to 4 cosine t plus 2 sine t. I should really call this rho, reminding myself that this is the density function. Now, to find the total mass, which is the line integral of the density function over the curve C that was described, I'm going to integrate from the lowermost t value to the uppermost t value, the integrand that I got by replacing the x and y with x of t, y and t, that's given here, 4 cos t plus 2 sine t plus 1, and multiplying that by the speed that we found, 2, and integrating that over all possible t values. But notice here, notice that this integral is just a single variable integral containing the letter t, which means fundamentally it's not any different from the integrals that we did back in calculus 2. Alright, so integrating this quantity, we have antiderivative of 4 sine t multiplied by 2, so that would be 8 in total, and then negative 2 cosine t multiplied by 2, so that would be 4 cosine t, plus integral of 1 t multiplied by 2, which would be 2t, evaluated from 0 to pi. Now plug in, that's a 4, plug in t equals pi to sine, that term vanishes. Plug in t equals pi to cosine, we get negative 1. So with the minus on negative 4, we get positive 1. Plus 2 times pi, whee! Jumped all the way up for unknown reasons. That one's all the way down here, strange. And now it's back. And now it's gone. Then plug in t equals 0. From sine, we get nothing. From cosine, we get positive 1. And so let's take away negative 1, and let's take away nothing from the final t term. And we get 8 plus 2 pi total mass. Okay, now when it comes to the center of mass, the same formulas apply here that we used so often back in calculus 1 and when we were doing double and triple integrals. If you want x bar, you can calculate the line integral of x rho xy and divide it by the total mass. And if you want y bar, you can do the line integral of y rho xy ds and divide that by the total mass. So let's consider the problem of finding these moments, line integral of x rho xy and y rho xy. X rho xy, or x times the quantity 2x plus y plus 1, can be simplified as 2x squared plus xy plus 1. And with x equaling 2 cosine and y equaling 2 sine, this becomes 2 times 4 cosine squared t plus 2 cosine t, 2 sine t plus, x reaches 1. We get x from that term. So this becomes 2 cosine t. Multiply by the speed, which we recall was 2, and we get 2 times 2 times 4, 8, cosine squared t, 2 times 2 times 2, another 8, cos t sine t, and then finally 2 times 2 cos t, we have 4 cos t. Okay, so then to find the moment in the around the y-axis, we would integrate as t goes from 0 to pi this quantity. So, once again, because of this cosine squared, we're going to need to use the trig identity, where this is equal to 1 plus cosine 2t. then rewrite on all the other terms. And then we can take the antiderivative. And we have 4t, we have plus 2 sine 2t. If we apply a u substitution with u equals sine, we can think of this as 4 sine squared t. And then finally, plus 4 sine t, evaluated as t goes from 0 to t equals pi. Now, every single one of these sine terms is going to vanish when t is equal to pi, and it's going to vanish when t is equal to 0. So the only quantity that survives for the moment around the y-axis is 4 times 2 pi, 4 times t equals pi, rather, which is 4 pi. And that would mean that x bar, for example, which is the moment around the y-axis divided by the total mass, could be found by taking 4 pi, moment around the y-axis, and dividing it by this total mass that we found in the previous calculation, which was 8 plus 2 pi. You can reduce this if you want, but it doesn't matter too much. This is, for example, how we would find x bar, and then I will leave y bar to you as an exercise because it's very, very similar to what we just did, and I don't want to waste your time doing something that's too redundant. All right. Now, just as a quick final note, if you have a function of 3 variables and c is a smooth curve in 3 dimensions, that has a parameterization that's 3-dimensional, then you can still calculate the line integral over c of x, y, z. You can just do almost the same formula. You take the parameterization, and you take the limits of that parameterization, and then you take the components of that parameterization and plug them into the function. And then you multiply by the parameterization's speed and integrate that from start to finish. That is the 3-dimensional equivalent for a mass of something like a wire or a string that's being thought about in 3-dimensional space. Okay, that's all there is to say about line integrals. Now, finally, one last comment that has to do with today's concept check, which is that does the choice of parameterization matter? There are usually lots of different ways to parameterize any given curve. You can parameterize it at speed 1, you can parameterize it at speed 2, you can parameterize it forward or backward, and all kinds of things. Does the choice of parameterization affect the outcome of the line integral? You'll be exploring that in today's concept check.